Thank you for visiting my channel, and remember to hit that subscribe button and click that bell icon so that you will be notified on our daily video releases.
The police, the same way, they put their club upside your head and then turn around and accuse you of attacking them. Every case of police brutality against a Negro follows the same pattern. They attack you, bust you all upside your mouth, and then take you to court and charge you with assault. What kind of democracy is that? What kind of freedom is that? What kind of social or political system is it when a black man has no voice in court, has nothing on his side other than what the white man chooses to give him? My brothers and sisters, we have to put a stop to this. And it will never be stopped until we stop it ourselves. They attack the victim, and then the criminal who attacked the victim accuses the victim of attacking him. Yes, sir. This is American justice.
Yes, sir. That's right.
This is American democracy.
Yes, sir.
And those of you who are familiar with it,
yes,
know that in America, democracy is hypocrisy.
Right.
Now, if I'm wrong, put me in jail.
Right.
But if you can't prove that a democracy is not hypocrisy, then...
Hello, everyone. Welcome to Current News Events with Sandra. I hope that you're having a fabulous day today. Well, on my channel today, I would love to share with you some new information that's coming out of the New York area, and it pertains to the assassination of Malcolm X. And new information has been brought to light about how the FBI and the NYPD played a part in his assassination. Now, we always knew that did happen, but nobody had any kind of concrete information or people who would admit to being involved with the assassination of Malcolm X. Well, a former police officer who was undercover with the Nation of Islam, and his name is Ray Wood, as you see to the right of this picture, he has released a letter. He died this past November 2020. He wrote a letter back in 2011 and told of his involvement through the NYPD and the FBI with the assassination of Malcolm X. So what I'd like to do with you now is share some backstory on this information. And once you get into this video, please click on the link that opens up this article that you're looking at, because it will give you a lot of information about this ongoing investigation of the assassination of Malcolm X. So let me give you some back information on this new development. New claims surrounding Malcolm X assassination surfaces in a letter written on former NYPD officer's deathbed. "I have carried these secrets with my heart, with a heavy heart," Ray Wood wrote. New allegations surrounding the death of Malcolm X have surfaced in a letter written by a former New York Police Department officer on his deathbed. On January 25th, 2011, Ray Wood, he's still alive then, who was serving as an undercover police officer on the day of Malcolm X's death, wrote, now he wrote this in 2011, he wrote a letter in which he admitted he participated in actions that in hindsight were deplorable and detrimental to the advancement of my own black people. When Wood was hired by the NYPD in 1964, his job was to infiltrate civil rights organizations to find evidence of criminal activity so the FBI could discredit the subjects and arrest its leaders, Wood wrote in the letter obtained by ABC. And that's the program that a lot of people are talking about now, just like in the assassination of Fred Hampton, the COINTELPRO program. And this is the program right here that was in effect back in 1969. And in my opinion, they're still running this program right now that we see right before our eyes with the happenings of the NFAC. But as pertaining to the assassination of Malcolm X, Wood wrote that as he faced failing health, he was concerned that the family of Thomas Johnson, one of the men convicted of killing Malcolm X, would not be able to exonerate him after Wood died. Johnson, Wood states, was arrested at the Audubon Ballroom the night that Malcolm X was killed, and he was arrested to protect Woods' cover and the secret of the FBI and the NYPD, Woods wrote. Now, this right here is such a powerful, powerful omission, because we always knew that this is what was going on behind the scene, but was no way that we really got anybody to step forward and admit to what they knew in the assassination of Malcolm X. So what I'd like to do right now, like I always do, I'd like to share a short video of the news coverage on this this new breaking development with the assassination of Malcolm X, which occurred February 21st, 56 years ago. And now some of the justification of what went on in his assassination is coming to the forefront. And we as Black people should demand justice for Malcolm X, even if it's been over 56 years ago. So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I would love for you to look at the short news footage that gives you some information on these events. As I said, please read the full article, because it really gives you a whole lot more of information than what I'm sharing with you on this video. And with that being said, after you watch the video, let's talk about what we're seeing, and I'd like to ask you a few questions. So let's take a look at the news footage.
That the NYPD and the FBI conspired to have their father assassinated.
56 years later, a letter given to Malcolm X's daughters could hold proof the NYPD and the FBI conspired to have him killed.
I am relieved that I am able to share this truth with the world today.
Reginald Wood reads the words of his cousin, former undercover cop Raymond Wood, who died in November. He wrote that letter in 2011 to be released upon his death.
It was my assignment to draw the two men into a felonious federal crime, so that they could be arrested by the FBI.
Those men were members of Malcolm X's security detail and were arrested days before his assassination.
There was no security to prevent the gunmen from coming into the building.
Three members of the Nation of Islam were convicted of the murders. The Manhattan District Attorney's Office began a preliminary review last February. After the letter's release, it says their review remains active and ongoing. As for the NYPD and the FBI, they say they have turned over all their relevant records to the DA and will cooperate.
Well, everyone, this is the new information that's coming out this past week out of New York, specifically February the 21st, 2021, about this letter that has been made public now from this undercover informant. You see him in the right on this photo. His name was Ray Wood. This is him back in 1964, 1965, when he had infiltrated the Nation of Islam. Also, if you read his history, he also infiltrated the Black Panthers and brought a big case against them. And now he's died this past November 2020. But back in 2011, he wrote a letter that he had given to his nephew to be released to the public after he died. And he had a lot of remorse for the role that he played in these undercover operations. But just thinking, I mean, I don't feel sorry for him or anything, but just think of the situation that he's in And he lived through all this. He knew the inside story on the COINTELPRO program. He was part of that program. And now in 2020, he lived to 2020, and he got to see the horrible predicament that black people are still in. And I know he has to wonder, what if he was not part of Malcolm X's assassination? What if there was not an assassination of Martin Luther King? What if there was not an assassination of Fred Hampton of the Black Panthers? You know, where would black people be today? Because we had nationalistic warriors who were on the front line fighting for a better life for their people, and their own people betrayed them. So my question after listening to and reading this, when are we ever going to learn to stick together no matter what? You don't have to like a person. You don't have to agree, but we're all in the same boat together. I mean, because you see this every day with Trump. His people are sticking behind him no matter what, because what? He is one of them. Just like Malcolm was one of us. Fred Hampton was one of us. Martin Luther King was one of us. Jam Master Jay with the NFAC is one of us, you know. And if we do not learn how to stick together and move on one accord, we're going to be in the same boat 50 years from now. We're going to be gone, but our children are going to be living in the same hell as second-class citizens in the United States if we don't get our act together and learn how to stand up and move together on one as one and fight for our rights peacefully. So with that being said, everybody, this is my rant, because it just makes me so mad that we never ever learn, and we're just like hamsters on that spin wheel. We're spinning and never get off because we never learn the lessons. Well, with that being said, the question I like to ask you today is, do you feel that these FBI programs, like you're listening and learning about from the 60s, if they still are in place today? And do you think that if they're in place, that they have people that are functioning in the same capacity as these individuals had done in the 60s, infiltrating these groups? And do you feel that we as black people, that they're putting these things in motion again today to stop black people from uniting? So the question I really wanted to ask is, do you feel that these FBI programs, are they still in place today? So with that being said, ladies and gentlemen, I hope that you found some value out of today's video. And I would love for you to subscribe to my channel and hit that bell icon so that you will be made aware of my daily video releases. Take care and have an awesome day.